Now that we know how to identify outliers, the thing we need to do, as stated earlier, is check out the outlier values to see if it's likely that the data are incorrect. For example, in our last sample data, if the age in one of the observations was 299, then we would be justified in deciding that this was some sort of reporting or entry error. Possibly the correct age was 29, and an extra 9 was added. Or maybe there really was a 99-year-old student attending community college, and someone mistakenly put a 2 in front of the correct value. The best course of action in this case is to try to go back to the original source to determine the correct data. But if that's not possible, then the best thing to do is to delete the record from the dataset. So what if we don't have an obvious error and we aren't certain whether the data is accurate or not? If we have a situation such as the two instances above, where it could be correct, but it's just abnormal, then the analysis and modeling process should include that data. That said, it is legitimate to create models without the data as well, to compare results, but it should be noted which models do and don't contain the outliers. Since we're talking about business analysis, someone within the business will need to make a decision as to which model to work with, but what shouldn't happen is to just drop the outlying observations just because it'll be easier to work with. On the other hand, if, like in our first example, the outlier didn't really change the results, where in our example the regression line retained its original slope, then it can be legitimate to remove that observation. Another way that analysts can work with outliers is called truncation. This is an instance, for example, where we know that a certain value can only be below a given maximum, and yet a value is reported above that. It might make sense to keep the observation and just truncate the value down to the maximum. An example of this might be if we were analyzing training effectiveness for a classroom, and we knew that the class could hold only a certain number of students, say 20, and yet an observation reported 40. Here it might make sense to change the value to 20 rather than eliminate the observation entirely. But keep in mind, any time those types of decisions are made, we should make sure it is noted in the report of the process.